Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and we are back finally playing a little bit more Durango Wildlands, and a lot has changed. I've been very busy since the last video. I'm now level 30, I've just been grinding away doing some missions, so I'm going to update you on our new home. A lot of things have changed around here, and then we're going to head off and try some brand new stuff, including some new islands and all this kind of stuff. I want to thank you guys so much for the friend requests. There's like 200 of you now on my friend list. I apologize I've not been able to play with you or accept party invitations. These are still sponsored videos. I can't really go off and do things like that at the moment, but I'm going to set up a clan that is going to be a thing, so we'll all be able to play together hopefully down the line. Now, let's do our update. First things first, yes, Chris, I am doing a video now. First things first, this is my new Pictoraptor. This is my current mount. Now, remember, last video we had a striped Compsognathus as our pet. We've now replaced it with the Pictoraptor. We're going to feed him, like so. He's a hungry little goose. And our striped Compsognathus named Bartholomew, I think. Yes, Bartholomew is there having a good time. He's actually currently producing things. He's got some XP and some animal droppings. So what you can do is you can feed your stationed dinosaurs. You can see I've got these new pens. These are holding pens rather than taming pens. You can feed them and then they'll produce stuff. Usually dung, unfortunately, but sometimes some pretty cool stuff. And you see here I've got a zebra ceratops as well. So the idea, my goal, in all honesty, is to basically collect every single dinosaur in the game. I'm going to be a dinosaur collector. So I'm going to tame them in this pen and I'm going to move them into these pens. And we can get bigger and better pens down the line. I'm going to put the feces in there. So this is my camp. Now you can see I've started to build the fence. There's my main door. It's always open and the fences are useless, but it just feels good. I've got this, which we'll look at in a second. Here's my little fire sitting area with some chairs and my little house. I even put a window in it. I had to build the window, but I built a little house, only a 1x1. You can only go up to 2x2 at this point, but we may have to upgrade because it is tiny, but there's a bed in there. What else do you need? There's a bed and a window. And okay, that's about it. We've got some torches. We've got another gate over here. Actually, should be finished. Yup. Oh, and a little bit of door. No? Well, come here. There we go. Beautiful. Oh, that's a door rather than a gate. I didn't even realise I did that. Well, there you go. That looks worse. I'll have to replace that. And we've got a brand new road sign. Now, you remember last video, we had a road sign with my little weird Godzilla thing. This time, we're going to make a bigger one. So let's draw on it. Let's colour this in, first of all. Again, we're going to go for... I'm going to try to make a dinosaur, right? It was hard last time because it was so small. Now we've got a big, chunky one. Hopefully, we can make it look a little bit more like a dinosaur with my expert drawing skills. Okay. There's the mouth. Goes down. Gets a little arm. Goes down again. Leg comes out. I've built this too small to the ground. I realise that. Tail. It's a little bit weird, but it's not the worst thing I've ever built. It does sort of look a little bit iffy down there in the bottom corner, but we'll ignore that. Let's try to give it an eye. Is there a white? That's sort of a white. And then a dark colour. We'll go for the brown. There we go. Looking nice. Give him some spines. Why not? Bam, 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 bam. Beautiful. And then... hi. Nope. Ah, made a mistake. Ha. Nope. Stop it. Stop that. Hi. Beautiful. It's a masterpiece, ladies and gentlemen. It's an absolute masterpiece. You see, I'm wielding my new two-handed knife. I can't remember what it's called. I think it's just a two-handed metal knife or two-handed something knife. I've kind of got a handle of the game. I've got to say, I finally feel like I know how the game functions and how it works. It is a complex game at times. It's very easy to get into, but to understand all the systems will take a little... What are you doing, buddy? It will take a little bit of time. But yeah, I'm feeling pretty good right now. Like, I know how the combat works and stuff like that. I am tempted to respec. I think I want to go for one-handed weapons rather than two-handed weapons. But I'll quickly show you my inventory. So we've got some stuff. I did buy some gear on the shop. We've got some gloves and some lovely wooden shoes, which sounds incredibly comfortable. Got myself a fabric bag. And then how the weapon system works. So one of you very nicely explained this. This is my weapon, my two-handed stone knife. So that's locked. That means we don't use that to harvest. What you do use to harvest is the axe, the hammer, the knife, and the pickaxe. And they should all do different things. Hammering is for crafting, and I think getting bones. The axe is for cutting down trees, of course. The knife is used for a lot of general stuff, like collecting like reeds and things like that. And then the pickaxe, of course, is for boulders. So those are my work tools, and that's my weapon. And you lock your weapon, and therefore you don't use it as a work tool. I kind of got it in the bag, I've got to say. I'm feeling good about myself right now. So what are we going to do today? Well, we are going to head over to the docks, first of all. We may have to get some new gear here. What we're gonna do, we're gonna set off sailing, first of all. I'm gonna try out some new islands. So there's my island, Clara Island. There's the three islands we've already explored. I had a little look on the tropical island. But because we've just hit level 30, what we can do is move over here to the level 30 island in the Tundra Sea. And then eventually we... What's this? I'm gonna click this. Oh, hello. Nice. Anyways, so we're going to move over here to the Tundra Sea Island, an unstable island we're going to discover. If you discover a new unstable archipelago, all pioneer missions within the same sea will be reset. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Oh my god, look, there's three islands. Ah, complete previous stages pioneer missions to unlock. Very cool. So, we've got 9 indigenous animals on Anemoi Toledo. This is the very first time I've ever been on an alpine island, so we may need to get some better, like, warm weather gear, and the game will tell us if we do. But we'll have a little look. Let's take a peek. Tea stones! Nice. An academic researcher seems to have gotten lost during a site inspection. Would you mind lending a hand? Huh. Something strange going on here. In a situation like this, whoever figures it out first gets way ahead. As you carry out missions for these organizations, you'll make connections with some of the people in their network. Members of the network won't give you any information until you do something about the unstable archipelago's instability. Okay. But the game hasn't yelled at me about the cold, so maybe we're okay, actually, which is surprising. Everyone's going to be in much better gear than I am. I'm in straw. Everyone else looks fancy. That's okay. Okay, chapter 1. Okay, so we've got like a proper little... Okay. Got like a continuous growing pioneer mission thing for the very first time. I think a lot of these are level 30. Look at the elephant! Now that's a shop-bought item, but look at it! It's an elephant! I am cold. I can tell my character's a little bit chilly. Don't know if I can do much about that at this moment. So, let's get some quests. Just gonna pick all of these up. Get some fresh water. Cut some wooden bows. Gather fir pine nuts or hazel tree hazelnuts. The oiliest ones you can find, not a problem. And this is a new group called The Committee. They seem a little bit dodgy to me, if I'm honest, the committee, but we need to go kill a male megaloceros and bring back its leg bone. Very cool. Okay, I've got missions for days, so we're gonna head down here and hopefully do this mission. The combat has started. I've been annihilated by velociraptors at several points since I started last playing. Oh, can I heat myself up? I feel really bad for my character. She's freezing. Now we'll be fine. It's fine. It's all good. So we're going to head down here and find ourselves a megaloceros, which, tell you what, before we do that, let's check our skills, because I think we can level up a little bit. So we're looking at our melee specialization, that's pretty good, and our two-handed action. We probably don't need cleave, actually. So we're probably okay. We've got Sunder, which is a brand new two-handed move, it's really, really strong. And combat stance level 3 now for our attack stance. I don't think we need anything else there. I'm nearly finished with the career guide as well. Look, Architecture 101, 96%. We're just trying to make a small personal box, but I need to get a level 30 for that, and we're not quite there yet. We've got 4 to go. Okay, let's go. Look at the... Everyone's so much better than me. I feel unequipped for my situation. That's not a male megalosaur. Oh, that's a male. Okay. I'm a little nervous about this, but let's give it a go. Sunder! Oh, look at that damage! Oof! Sunder's my big move. Hits like a truck, though! Oh, God. Hits like an absolute truck! Oh, come on. How much stamina only for 70 for Sunder? I'm just gonna take this hit and then we're gonna Sunder. Oh. Come on! Bam! There we go, good stuff. He's on the ground. Get in there, Pictoraptor! Beat him up! Help me! Assist me, please! Nearly there. I'm gonna dodge, I think. That's too early. Ugh! The damage! Come on, it's nearly done! This might finish it. Nice! Look how I nearly died. I literally nearly died. Even in all honesty, I don't think I'm actually ready for this island. I just want to, you know, try it out. Basically, oh no, I can't see the Megaloceros. There it is. Right, we can get the leg bone. That's cool. You can see how I'm not really equipped for a lot of this stuff here. because my gathering is just a little bit too low. I get the feeling that even at level 30, you maybe shouldn't go to a level 30 island. You should probably spend a little bit more time on the 25s and go from there. But we've done that quest. We need an oily liquid. So we're looking for like a hazelnut. Ah, wasn't there something about the fur? Am I going crazy? Pine nuts. I need fruit too. Yep, we can get that. Let's grab that. I feel so bad for my character. Chris, this is exceptionally rude. Alright, there we go. That's that quest done as well. Level 20 or higher wooden bow. Now, I've got to be honest. Oh, there we go. We've got a little babby. Look at the little babby. That's three of the creatures discovered already. Now, I've got a little bit lazy. So I need a level 20 or higher wooden bow. So what I do tend to do, because my specialty is in construction, right? That's where I've put all my skill points, construction and fighting. Those are my two big things. A little bit of gathering. So I'm not the best at making weapons. I'm not the best at crafting tools. So what you do instead is you go into the market. You search for the item you're looking for. You set the correct level, which is 20. You search, and 299. Oh wait, that's a limb though. I need an actual wooden bow. Ugh, 1500, that's quite expensive actually. But there's no other way for me to do the quest. I've got 25,000, I'm moderately well off at the moment. So, you know, knock it out. We also need some water. So let's go do that. Tell you what, let's ride our Pictoraptor, shall we? Look at that, beautiful. You can see how my gear seems inappropriate. Though, it seems to have warmed up a little bit. I don't think I'm freezing to death anymore, which is nice. Okay, so that's the plan. We're going to do a couple missions, then we're going to head back to the other island, because I know on the past island... Hello? Oh, you're so cute! Look at him rolling around. Oops, sorry, buddy. I know on the past island there are some proper raptors. Not that I don't love my Pictoraptor, but... Oh, no. Hey! No, I called you cute! Why are you doing this to me? Just run away for a few seconds and we should be okay. Nice! There we go. Right. Right. Oh. Oh my god, that's my favorite bug I've ever seen. I've never seen this one before. That is blowing my mind. I love it. Oh no, she got... Oh, I had to... Oh, I'm sad that I stopped. I should have done that forever. Should have never... This would have been the end of Durango, but it would have been worth it. Oh, we have a dire wolf. Never seen one of those before. Don't want... Oh my god, there's a lot of direwolves. Okay, we're going to run away slightly. that's not looking safe. We're going to move away from the direwolves. There's like 20 of them. Creatures in this game have started to group up quite a lot more. I can see the benefit of cleave. When it comes to like the raptors, there's like 20... Oh, there's all my glossaurus again. When it comes to the raptors, I was getting attacked by about 20 of them at once. I'm a little bit apprehensive that we're not going to have to tame one, but we'll give it a good old college try. Hello. Got ourselves some centrosauruses. Very cool. Right next to a little crater over here. Loads of cotton plants. Let's turn that off. That. I'm being chased by Suarez. Look at the centros! Very cool. Oh, no, not very cool. Not very cool. Ah! Leave me alone. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. They're very cool, though. They are very cool looking. Let's grab this warp hole whilst we're here. I've run around quite a lot of the map already. Hello? Coelophysis. Curious. Right, I've never seen Coelophysis before. I'm not sure if I can tame one. It might be possible to tame the Coelophysis. So I'm just going to get away so I don't die. We'll have a quick little look at our skills. Survival. Animal taming. Right, what can we currently get? We can get Deinonychus, Ophiraptor, Pictoraptor, Albiraptor, Raptor, Snowfield, Coelophysis, and Coelophysis. Very cool. And we can also get... Yeah, that's it for now. So, we're going to try to tame the Coelophysis. I only want one at a time, please. Come on, buddy. Come on. Right, maybe I should heal. That's real. It'll be fine. It's only a level 30. It's got no health. It's fine. One Sunder will bash its half to death. Although, not if I do that. Sometimes the combat feels really automatic, but you can actually move around and you can miss and you can hit different parts of them to do more damage and stuff like that. It's actually a bit more in-depth than I considered it, to be honest. Don't you hurt my Pictoraptor, buddy. Right, I'm just going to Sunder one more time. Oh, why the pain? Come here. Ugh. There we go. Right, I want to hurt it a little bit more. Okay, go for the cat. Oh no, it died! Oh! I didn't mean to kill it! I just suddenly did a massive hit at the end. Oh, I'm sorry, buddy. I was going to take you home with me, but I've murdered you instead. It's not quite what I was aiming for. I'm going to chow down on some of this lovely meat-stuffed bread. Tons of energy from this. The meat is overflowing with juices. Tell me about it, ladies. Come here. Come here. I just need to pull it away from its friend a little bit. Come on, Sunder. Oh, that's the stuff. So Sunder's the kind of move you want to do when they're not going to move away, basically. Okay, I'm gonna just go for the capture now, because otherwise I'll kill it. Please capture. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Nice! First try, baby! Okay, cool. So, I wasn't able to really find a Dodophysis or the mushrooms. The stone pillars isn't that hard. I'll probably end up crafting, buying them, if I'm honest. Well, I explored a little bit. There's still more to go, so we can definitely go back. But now we're going to go home. We're going to put our Coelophysis in the taming pen. And then we're also going to make a new taming pen and go find ourselves a Velociraptor. Okay, we have all the materials we need. Definitely didn't cheat. Whoa, it's a monster. It's an absolute monster. Right, let's put that. I tell you what, I've got a little slot over here on the right-hand side. Which is going to be perfect for this over here. There we go. Look at that. There's absolutely nothing in here right now. Craft. Small. This is a small pen. It's absolutely ginormous. But what we should be able to do is raise multiple dinosaurs in here simultaneously. Same with the holding pens. Right now you can really only fit one dinosaur in at once. Eventually we should be able to fit multiple in, which is going to be super duper helpful. This is a hell of a project. Fill automatically, go. This might take a few hours to build, now that I think about it. But that's okay. It fits in there perfectly, that's beautiful. Yeah, 4 hours, Jesus. How much they instantly... Okay, screw it. That's super expensive and totally a terrible idea, but I'm doing this for you, YouTube. So the pen area is up to 60 now, whereas this one over here is only 25, so this is more than double the size. I wonder, can we move... Okay. What we're going to do is actually tear this one down. We don't need that rubbish anymore. I'm probably going to end up tearing all these down and replacing them with new pens as well, but we shall see. Right, so let's put him in here instead. We give him some food, cheer him up a little bit. Got tons of meat. Ladies. There we go. Actually speeds up the taming time a little bit as well. Very, very slightly. Really by a tiny amount. But it makes him a little bit happier. You can see the Coelophysis is quite a difficult creature to tame. You know, he's very unhappy at the moment. Despite I gave him tons and tons of food. Maybe he wants better food. But look, he's barely making a dent. He's a cheeky little so-and-so. Well, I found a dead raptor. That suggests there's a raptor seal. Oh, yep, there's definitely a raptor seal. Let's grab the crater and let's move away. There's many, many... I don't really want to fight two of them at once. They're pretty vicious things. Look how much damage that did alone. If I can pull just one away, that'll be good. There we go, there we go. Oh, no, there's two there. Come on, buddy. Come on. Come on. Just you on your own. Maybe just your friend over here. Is your friend cute? Turn off that. Nope. There we go, there we go, there we go. Right, let's go. Attack! Oh no, there's multiple! Oh no, no, no. Oh, the damage! Alright, we're gonna go for a really quick tame here. It's gonna be... Oh my god, it worked! Right, we just need to kill this one without dying, and then we're good. Kill its friend! Kill its friend! Oh, this two-handed sword! Oh, the damage is insane! You know what? I think it's time to run. I think it's time to run away. Oh, my Pictoraptor, no! Oh, I'm so sorry, I've left him behind to die. Oh, there we go. Honestly, the raptors are fine on their own. You can... Oh, hello, guys. Saurolophus. You can do a lot of damage to them, especially at the moment. I'm hitting like a truck. I really am. But they really hurt. I feel like, offensively, I'm very strong, but defensively, I feel squishy, to say the least. I really feel squishy. Anyways, Velociraptor caught, not tamed. None of the dinosaurs, at least the high level ones, are guaranteed tame. You can increase that chance, I think, with better pens and stuff like that. We'll have to see. Although the coelophysis was 75% on both, so maybe that's not the case. Either way, got ourselves a Velociraptor, hopefully. We're going to stick it in the pen, see what it's going to do, and then in the next video, if we're coming back, then we shall have a coelophysis and a Velociraptor. We're going to have to make more pens, like holding pens as well, now that I think about it. Can I put them in together without them murdering each other? Let's go find out. Here's my lovely pen, there's my coelo, and animal handling, plus... Well, you can fit together. We can actually put yet another dinosaur in there if we wanted to. It's all so unhappy. There you go. I'm going to give you lots of meat. So it seems the coelophysis and the Velociraptor are the same. They're different levels. The coelophysis is slightly higher. But they're both 75% success rate. And they're both very, very unhappy. And they both take 3 hours. But they are living together. It's cool, isn't it? The one thing I would like to do is also upgrade our current ones. Our makeshift pens into... small pens. It's a lot of money. I don't need it right now. You know, we only have these dinosaurs. But when these guys are done, we're going to have 5 dinosaurs and only 2 holding pens. So we're going to have to do something about that. But we'll see next time around. Right. We're going to end it there then. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. We will come back down the line. I want to go stab next to them, I think. we will come back in the future with... probably look at clans and civilized islands. I'm gonna make, tell you what, we'll do it right now. I'm gonna make my own clan. Wait, no, I need to come up with a name. Okay, leave name suggestions down below for clan name suggestions. And I believe once we've made a clan, we'll be able to move on to a civilized island and we'll all be able to build together and live together. I think you maybe have your own domains on those islands, but the point is we'll all live on the same island. We're gonna deal with all that stuff in the next video. And hopefully I can play with you guys properly from next time on. It's not going to happen every time, people understand that, right? Because, you know, I have to do videos, have to be a professional YouTuber. But yeah, we can definitely do some stuff together, that'd be really cool. And thank you guys at home for watching me and supporting this little series so far. If you do like the video, please hit the like button to let me know that you want a part 4. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, myself as always, bye bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.